actually working on another project about another serial killer. And quite early on into that, we found out that there was a competing project as a film was coming out based on the same true life case. So we kind of looked around for another real life serial killer case we could base that on. And I sort of looked around different true crime sort of resources. And then I found the story of the Axeman. So I found the story of the Axeman, and it was quite intriguing. It was an interesting series of crimes. And then I started to research a bit more broadly at the city and the time and what was going on sort of in the area at that time. And that was what really fascinated me and made me want to write the book. It was more the city the killer was in and the time period. It was a real crossroads. It was a really interesting historical period. So that's what sort of fascinated me about it. New Orleans was really interesting because there were a lot of things going on in the city at the time. The main one was the birth of jazz, which was happening in the nightclubs and the cabarets in the city at the time. Then the war had just finished, so you had a lot of servicemen coming back from Europe looking for work, and there was a lot of dissatisfaction among them. So the other interesting thing that happened, New Orleans used to have a legalized red light district, which closed down in 1917. And that caused a lot of social changes in the city because a large part of the city relied on that for its income. It led to the dispersion of jazz musicians around the country as well. That's sort of one of the plot points in the book. And one of the other interesting things is the New Orleans Mafia was sort of rising to prominence at the time. So you had kind of like this intersection of the war, the jazz music, the mafia. And then in the middle of all this, you had this serial killer that sort of turned up and started killing people and writing letters to the newspapers. So one of the big influences on the structure was a short story called In a Bamboo Thicket by a writer called Akuta Gawa, who, it's a similar kind of setup. There's a crime and there's a court case with four witnesses looking into the crime, and each witness's testimony contradicts the previous ones. So the reader's kind of left to decide which of the four people was telling the truth. There's kind of some hints in there where you can possibly figure out one of them's more likely to be true than the other one. That short story was combined with another one of his short stories and made into the film Rashomon by Akira Kurosawa, which is one of my favorite films. And it plays with that same structure of different narrators and protagonists contradicting each other and leaving the sort of reader confused. So there's something similar going on in my book as well. You've got the three detectives looking at the same crime, each of them reaching different conclusions. And the idea was, it's less of a whodunit as a who's right, who's gonna catch the killer first. I'm working on a sequel to the book with the same characters, and they've moved to another city, to Chicago. So it's set sometime later with most of the same characters in it. We catch them at a later period in their life. This was a time when Louis Armstrong had moved to Chicago in the Prohibition era. He was working in a club which was run by Al Capone. So there's a kind of swinging, roaring 20s, Prohibition era sort of feeling to the sequel, which I'm working on at the moment.